So now we'll see about the use of buffered reader, and we'll see some of the program that will get the input from the user with the help of buffered reader. So far we have created some application without getting the values in the runtime, and what we are passing is we are passing the value inside the program itself like that. For example, we are assigning the value of name here in the program itself. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a program which will get the content from the user in the runtime. Then we'll execute that program. For that, we should have something called buffered reader. And this buffered reader plays a major role in getting the input from the user during the runtime. And this buffered reader is having the exception handling mechanisms. So first we'll cover this buffered reader, then we'll go for that exception handling. Okay, so now let me create a notepad. So I'll create this as like class input from user. I will have like something like public static void main string args. The classical thing. Okay, so now in C program we can get the content from the user, or we can get the data from the user with the help of scam statement. Similarly, in C++ we will use something called C in, but in Java it's like a different way in which you can get. So there are two possible ways in which you can get the content. Like one, we can use buffered reader, and another one is scanner. So both are having some like advantages and some functionalities are there. But I will use something called buffered reader for my program. So this buffered reader, it's a predefined class in Java, in which it is capable of getting input from the user, and it's storing in something called buffer like that. So you can able to see that in the package, Java P. So this Java P is an abstract command which can be used for getting the abstract part of any class. So Java P space Java dot io dot buffered reader, because this buffered reader provides the input, or this user can provide the input to the buffered reader, and it can also print the output like that. So it comes under the package called java.io.bufferedReader. So when you press enter, you can see. So these are the main functionalities we can do with the help of buffered reader. So this buffered reader, you can see this buffered reader, IO buffered reader is extending java.io.reader. That means that here also there is an inheritance, and we can have the constructor like buffered reader here. Then we can have read line, etc. So let me not get confused with it. So now the thing is, like, when you want to use buffered reader, you have to import the package java.io.star. So what you can do is you can import the package java.io.star like that. That means it can have all the packages. It can inherit all the classes inside java.io. In particular, if we want to use buffered reader, you can use buffered reader also. So first thing is, when you want to get the content from the user, you have to use import java.io.star. Okay, then what happened is, like, when you use this kind of buffered reader, sometimes like it is possibility the possibility like the user can give some improper result. For example, the program is asking you to enter some age of a person, but instead of giving age of a person, if you give some like ABC like that, it will give an error. So to avoid that, there is a exception handling mechanism in which it will provide. So to use that exception handling mechanism, you can use something called throws exception. That we'll use the concept of exception handling in the next in the upcoming sessions. So this is how, when you want to use a buffered reader, the first thing is you have to import the package, import java.io.star. Then similarly, to avoid the problems when you give an improper result, it will give an improper result, and to avoid that, we'll use some exception handling mechanism. And what I will do is I will just write a program like system.out.println. Enter your name like that. I'm going to get that from user. Enter your name like that. Then I'm going to create the very big line buffered reader br equal to new buffered reader. First we have to create the object for the buffered reader for getting the value. Then this buffered reader, the main purpose of the buffered reader, it will read the content which inside the buffer. So we have to use something called new input stream reader of system.in. So this, it's a very big line. You have to understand, for getting the input from the user, you have to use this line. Buffered reader br equal to new buffered reader. It's a class. We are creating an object called br. In the constructor parameter, we are going to pass this new input stream reader, because when you give input, when it get the content from the user, it is said to be input. So it will be reading in the form of streams. So it is new input stream reader. And system.out.println is for printing the value. System.in is for getting the value. Okay. So to get some value from the user, we have to use something like this. So what happens is if you give enter your name Raja or like that. So what it will do is it will get the value using this one. It will get the value using this new input stream reader system.in, and it will store that in a buffered reader. How will you read that from the buffered reader? So there are plenty of methods. There is read is option is there, and read line is option is there. So there are plenty of ways in which you can read the content. So to read that, what I will do is I will create a variable called string name equal to br.readline like that. So readline is the method that is associated with buffered reader, which will get the content from the user and it will store it in name, and we will print that like that. So you can put the name as plus name. So I will save this as input from user. So I will use Java C space input from user dot Java. Okay, input instead of input stream, I have given input stream. So I just change, compile it. Yeah, then Java space input from user. So when I press enter, it will ask you to enter the name. So I'll just give my name. When I press enter, you'll get the result. So the concept is very simple. If you want to get the content from the user, the runtime, we will use this buffered reader. Buffered reader is a class. It is like a buffer in which it will store some data, and using some new input stream reader, it will get the content from the user and it will store it in the buffer. To read the content from the buffer, we have to use the readline method. Okay. So any doubt in this concept? Can you all hear me actually? And I got a message they can't able to hear my voice like that. Yeah. Okay, fine. Okay, so now this is all about getting content from the user and storing that into a variable. Okay, any doubt in this buffered reader? You can put it in chat. Okay, so what happens? I am getting the value as a string because the name is a string, and by default this read line will get the result as string. What happens if I want to use something like integer? Okay, so I will do that program for it. For example, instead of like enter your name, so you have to give enter your age like that. So instead of like I will give int age, then the ages plus age. Plus it like that. Now I'm trying to save this. Now you'll get the error, right? So I can't able to convert the string into integer. As we know that when the Java takes any input as string. So in the previous case, we are able to store the name in a string, but here I can able to store string in a like string, but here I can't able to store a string in a integer. So that is the error I am getting. So to overcome that, in Java there is something called wrapper class.
Wrapper class.
Let me mute all the parts. Okay. So there is a wrapper class. So there is a wrapper class in which it will allow us to convert the given string into integer, like integer to string or to string into a float like that. So there is a wrapper class. You can see that wrapper class here. So Java P space Java dot IO dot integer like that. I think it's not integer. Maybe check. Okay, it's not integer. It's Java dot Java P space Java dot lang dot integer. So there you can see this integer wrapper class. There is an option called parseInt. You can see there is an option called parseInt, which will convert the given string into an integer. Okay, and this parseInt is a static method of the class integer. So how will you call the static method? We can use the class name integer. The class name is integer, followed by the static method parseInt of, followed by the parameter in which I'm going to pass. The parameter in which I'm going to pass is string. So now the concept is very simple. The class name is integer and the parseInt is like a method, it's a static method. We can call the static method of a class by including integer, that is a class name, dot method name called parseInt, followed by the parameter br.readline. br.readline is just a string value of the age. Now the age is converted to integer and it is stored in int age. So let me compile it. So Java C input from user dot Java. So Java input from user. So it will ask you to enter the age. I can give 22. So then the age is 22, like that. Okay. So any doubt in buffered reader? Any doubt? We can move or we can have some quick discussion.